Hey, buddy, it's Invictus. Time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. Happy Friday, Mosh Pit. It's Friday. Gotta get down on Friday. You know the song. We are dancing today, though, because we did have another video cross 3,000 likes. Now we're only 3 away from the keyboard tracking episode. And then beyond that, the next like tree goal, I know it's going to be one that people have been asking for, and I've got to mentally prepare for it. Let's put it that way. Get your meme of the day here. Screenshot of the day brought to you by Not Who You Think Maybe. That old thread was, what's the opposite of Sinvicta Navigation? Yep. That is something that is incredible. If you don't know what we're looking at here, just look at the mini-map and realize that he's in Void. And, yeah. They got to Delirium very, very quickly. Let's put it that way. I've never seen a shorter trek to Delirium. So congrats on that one. Thank you very much for the screenshot and everyone who upvoted it. Whoa there. Seed Day is gonna be 07 Sierra Tango, Quebec to Juliet Golf. We've got good stats to start off with. We have way above average tiers actually. Good damage, very bad shot speed though, and not great movement speed. But our range is awesome, though. We're also starting with the Filigree Feather, which is very, very interesting. And I mean very interesting, in like a Mr. Ed sort of way. We're looking at possibly going Angel Dealers here, y'all. I mean, I'm just going to be straight up just honest with you. Oh, baby. There's not too many space bar items that's going to make me be a little bit excited, but Anima Sola is definitely going to be one of them. Because obviously it gives you so much control over the enemies. We've talked about it just every single time, man. Like, Anima Sola is just so, so good, especially if you can combine it with anything that recovers charges on your space bar item, or if you have, like, the 9-volt or something like that. It is just primo. So, and of course, you can also use it against non-bosses, too. You can use it against spikes, you can use it against spiders, you can use it against anything that you really want. You should be here. A little bit of a reverse arrow action going here with those pots showing you the opposite way, which people are going to get even more confused about now, and that's okay. But the reason why we're excited here is because we have the Filigree Feather. The Filigree Feather is a trinket that's going to make angel statues drop angel deal items instead of key pieces. So if we get rocking and rolling like we were the other day with all those sacrifice rooms and whatnot, then we're looking at some big-time gains, and I mean big-time gains, like monster-sized gains, potentially. That's assuming that we get the angel deal items that, like, you know, we want and we actually need. That little block there by the rock. I don't mean Dwayne Johnson. I don't know why he would be here. That's one thing I've asked before. Like, I wonder who the most famous person is that watches these videos. And if there is anyone famous who watches these videos, would they be brave enough to even say anything in the comments? You know, like that's how I found out that Bikini Body watches my videos. So far, I believe he is the most famous person that I am aware of that watches these videos, or at least that's brave enough to say it, to like respond to that challenge and comment. So far the bar has been set for Bikini Body. With someone I talk to quite frequently and also watches streams all the time. You get an HP upgrade here. We could go in the curse room, but I'd rather save the Soul Heart. The Soul Heart's going to have to last a while because we're going for angel deals. All angel deals, baby. All right, Filigree Feather. Now I'm gonna give you the 411 here. I don't even know what that means, but it sounds cool. All right. So listen here, son. You're getting called up to the big leagues today. All right. We have a desperate need for you to get us some quality angel deal items. We should have never been hitting this room, by the way. And we're gonna need you to basically secure us some HP, some damage, obviously. Maybe some homing tiers. I'm not suggesting that you have to get a Sacred Heart on our very first angel deal, but if you feel like it, I'm not gonna stop you, okay? This movement speed is giving me a heart attack here. But we can buy the key if necessary. We can also bomb this chest over here because obviously we need to get into the item room, so yeah, we've already been to the secret room, so we're not gonna discover the secret room here, but maybe get a crawl space or something, or not. Okay, we get double our bombs back, so that's fine. We still need to get a key to get into the item room, however. There's a golden pill, which... I know. Who's Victor? Just take the golden pill. Give me Virgo, PhD, or Luckfoot, and then, yeah, sure, we got ourselves a deal. If we had more stats, I would rip the golden pill and just, you know, kind of have a little bit of fun, but... Yeah, we cannot afford to get a movement speed down or his tears down or anything down right now. But we do really, really, really want to find this item room, and we have to hope that there's something halfway decent in there. I would love a movement speed upgrade. Would love a shot speed upgrade. For once, our chief complaint is not lack of tears or damage. For once. I know, it's shocking. Animasola, by the way, will... basically root the closest enemy to Isaac, his general vicinity. Doesn't deal any damage, but you can also let go of the shackles early. If you want to, you can just break them. I don't know why you would ever want to do that unless you like had to make a really weird sort of dodge. Crack the Skizzle is... I do love Crack the Sky. Crack the Sky is a very, very good boss killer. As much as I love Animasola, we need to have something that can shut down bosses even more that isn't dependent on our tier damage. And Crack the Sky will be able to do that if it hits the target. Big old fat if it hits the target. And that kind of comes down to me. We want to use it on targets that are just single target like that. There we go. Animasola could not have done that. We get some shot speed. And we're going to get a tarot card, which is going to give us a reverse justice card. Okay. The reverse justice card is going to give us some chest. Now, if we get enough keys, we can use this inside of an angel deal. I don't know if they turn into eternal chests or not, but we can try it. Okay. Okie dokie. So, point of order here is to hopefully get ourselves an angel deal, I should say, on this floor. Hopefully we don't have to wait till floor 5, but, you know, Invicta luck and all that. And Animasola, it is great. It's made greater if you have the DPS to deal with stuff that you shackle. If you don't, and this is the logic here, because we don't have, like, a lot... I mean, our damage is okay. There's a sack room here, too. I just now noticed that. Because our damage is not incredible right now, we need something that can shut down bosses better than Animasola. And what better way to shut them down than by killing them? A little Brimmy here. Fortunately, no Tinted Rock. Sometimes it's the Tinted Rock in that particular item room. Secret room might be south of here. We have to look to see. Get a planetarium. I mean, I'm down for it, but a little bit odd. Secret room still could be to the right of here. We have 5 bombs. We can check. Okay. 20 cents now, 4 bombs and 2 keys. Make that 1. We get Mercurius, which is absolutely fantastic. So, if anything, Mercurius allows us just to get a solid movement speed upgrade. But obviously, the bigger draw here is going to be able to run through rooms that we don't want to be in or that we can't afford to be in. So, this is going to be a pivotal floor for us here. And of course, Invicta Navigation, I got stuck inside of the doorway. Invicta Navigation is completely countered by Mercurius. Unless, of course, I get stuck in the doorway and, like, can't dodge at all. That is the one downside to the Mercurius and also to the doorstop, is that if you move too far backwards, you'll end up kind of screwing yourself and just staying in the door frame and being unable to really go anywhere. So, this is going to give us, I believe, a shot speed upgrade. No, it's going to give us damage. Okay. Also going to spawn a key. Okay, so now we focus on making the sacrifice room the priority, and because we have the filigree feather, we need to start putting this plan into action. So what we're going to do is we're going to look for red hearts. We're going to look for maybe not soul hearts, but definitely trying to get as many red hearts as possible because we're going to need at least 8 HP to do this. And we do not have 8 HP right now. We don't have anything that can give us any HP either, which is a little bit unfortunate. But, like, we don't have old bandage. We don't have Gimpy. We don't have fanny pack or anything like that. So we have to get a little bit lucky here with the chest that we spawn. And we also... Another thing to keep in mind is that we also can't afford to get too overzealous. And we're going to get Goat Head, which is going to give us access to the Angel Deal. Now, hang on a second. Because that might give us some extra... That might give us some extra HP, but we're going to have to fight the Angel Statue, though, in order to make this really efficient. Which means that we can't tap the Sacrifice Room right now out of fear of safety for us ourselves right now. Because our damage, again, is not fantastic. Although the Consolation Prize did help out quite a bit, it's not the end-all be-all here. Really hoping this is going to be a wound room. Or womb room, I should say. But we do have another charge on Crack the Sky, so that is going to help us out and deal with the angel, whoever it is, either Uriel or Gabriel. And Crack the Sky is pretty good against them. The mind, okay. So it is going to be Gabriel. Gotta be careful with the purple fires here. Now, as soon as the purple fire shoots, it's not going to fire at you again. No pun intended there. Shot by little Brimmy. Yeah, so that's two fires that have shot at us, this one and that one. We get Divine Intervention, which... Divine Intervention can be okay. You have to be pretty proactive with your micro, and that can be a little challenging for some people. I'm sorry for all the back and forth here, but I want to test this justice thing real quick. Reverse justice card. I don't know if they have a chance of turning into eternal chest. I straight up just don't know. Okay. Stapler. Oh, come on, dude. You already fired us once, bro. I know you reset, but come on. Okay, so we got more money. Didn't gain any HP, unfortunately. So I think we're going to have to abandon this idea of being able to play the sack room here. Maybe we'll get a couple coins out of it. Get nothing. Yeah, so we don't quite have the ability, HP economy to do this quite yet. Mr. Me would be nice. Now, honestly, Magic Fingers wouldn't be bad either, but we're slowly making our way downtown here. Okay, so. We don't care about taking red heart damage, although obviously we don't want to take red heart damage. But Goat Head allows us to have a 50-50 shot at the Angel Deal or Devil Deal. Obviously, we would rather have the Angel Deals because of Filigree Feather. But if we don't, then it's not the end of the world. And because we have the Mind now, we're going to be able to... Essentially, we're going to be able just to run straight to the boss or straight to wherever we want to because of Mercurius. Mercurius, I should say. But something else to keep in mind is, remember, we want to try to get a full charge on Crack the Sky just so we have a boss killer still, because that situation is not going to change. Stapler helping us get over 6 damage. Kind of like it. Get Adrenaline, which the best thing about Adrenaline is that it contributes to Spun. And we get a soul heart, which is, I'm not going to say irrelevant. It's still good because obviously, you know, survivability and whatnot. Also got to start. I got to really stop saying and whatnot. It's cheap, uneducated filler music. World card. Okay. I mean, it contributes. It's 2 or 3 for spun already. Like, we don't really technically need a movement speed upgrade that badly, but I'll take it just because of spun. So adrenaline is going to help us get there, and then roid rage is going to take us a step further. Now we're only one away from getting spun, which would be a very nice upgrade if we can get it. Justice card. Back up to almost full HP now. Holy card. And Ace of Spades. Turns these all into keys. I'm just going to take them. The Holy card is going to give us a temporary Holy Mantle to. Again, we're just going to run straight through everything except to the boss room, obviously. So this will make up for some lost time on that second floor, and actually, even though like we're really, really far behind on in terms of time, we can still make boss rush. So 50-50 shot for Angel Deal, Devil Deal. We do get ourselves another Angel Deal, which is great. More HP, which is fine. I mean, I'm going to take Seraphim here. Seraphim is great because of the damage that it puts out. It does contribute to Conjoined, which is less than ideal, but you still get a very powerful familiar. It's going to go good with Little Brimmy, so Lazarus's Rags, okay. So if we end up, if we somehow end up getting Damocles or something like that, we'll have a little bit of protection against it. And Curse the Blind. Let's go check on this mini-boss. Oh, yeah, that's another thing. You can't run straight through to mini-bosses either. Gonna be Wrath. Wrath is fine. We should get a couple bombs out of here. Boom is not exactly what we're looking for. Yeah, we can just sort of skirt way past everything. And this is that sort of makeup timer that I was talking about, allowing us to be a little bit more flexible with our choices, because we can run straight to the, we can run straight to wherever we want to. Very cheap soul hearts there. I'll take one more blind item. 9 volt. I'll definitely take that. We might as well buy this key too. Absolutely love Mercurius for just the amount of. It's almost like a comfort item, you know? It's like, yeah, I don't feel like doing this room, so we're just gonna not. We're just gonna straight up just not. We're just gonna be like, all right, you know what, game? I appreciate that you try to throw this BS room into our way here, but aha! Now it is I who is throwing the BS in your way. We don't need more bombs. It's a little bit difficult to use Crack the Skizzle against Monstro, especially because of his propensity to just simply jump at the start. So, but if you get lucky, he ends up kind of derping out a little bit, and you can kind of freeze him in there. But this is one fight that I would say that Anima Sola is superior to than Crack the Skizzle. The range upgrade. We don't have any more bombs. We need to go get it. We need to go get a bomb. We didn't come all this way with the Filigree Feather to not be able to bomb every single angel statue that we got. All right. If I have to go down there and get Mr. Boom, I will. Fight the Golden Hollows here. It's just a quick little bit of money. We get some soul hearts as well. I would like to make boss rush if possible. I can see if there's a bomb in there. Okay, see if the journey was worth it here. So far, Filigree Feather has gotten us Divine Intervention and the Mitre. And Glyph of Balance. Glyph of Balance is, I mean, it's fine. like whatever you need, like the Glyph of Balance has got you covered, but we're not trading up. We're not trading Crack the Sky for Mr. Boom. I like Mr. Boom, don't get me wrong. He's great for whenever you need a bomb in a pinch, but yeah, he ain't no Crack the Skizzle. Get a full charge here real quick. I don't really want to take a blind item. Hey, we could have gotten bombs out of there. So there's not really anything that in the super secret room that we could really profit from right now. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to find the Fool card. It's not gonna be in here, but we can't leave anyway. That shouldn't be too difficult, but we're kind of pressed for time. Now, never mind. We get ourselves a Stars card. So let's go straight to the boss. Then we can teleport straight to the item room afterwards. Oh man, those are great. This is wonderful right here. We're gonna kill Mom. That is another fight that's Crack the Sky is not very good at, is the Mom fight. Yeah, that was probably the best that we could hope for there. Normally, it's pretty difficult to damage her with Crack the Sky. Why did you take that step? That's weird, man. Usually the fat spider walks directly downward, not at an angle like that. That's a very strange path. Kind of mad about it. Take a negative for damage here. Yeah, we don't need to actually fight this right now. We can come back because we have Goat Head, so. Tooth and Nail, Bob's Rotten Head. Gonna take Ouija board for the Spectral and the Tears up, and we also get Charm of the Vampire, which is gonna give us a damage up and the health recovery too. Get ourselves a Fool card. Extra money here. We didn't go into the shop yet, so I'm hoping that we can get some kind of curse immunity or something. We can actually bomb our way into this vault here, which we might as well do. Taking out these knights is not going to be really too much of a pain, especially with little Brimmy being here. And sometimes Seraphim shots can go up and around too. Let's bomb away the secret room, get another nickel here, and check out the Vizalt, which is going to give us a whole bunch of dimes and kizoins. Kizzies. Now, if I wanted to, I could have exited the door there and it would have stayed open for free, but since we didn't, it's still going to cost 2 keys to get in there, which, of course, we're never coming back to this place, so it's not on this run anyway. Wouldn't that be weird? One day, just think about that. One day, I will visit the Depths 2 for the last time. Isn't that crazy? Why did I buy that? There will come a day where I will go fight Mom for the very last time. I don't know if that's depressing or if that's, like, interesting to think about. Maybe a little bit of both. But there will come a time where I will have started my last Isaac Seed. And hopefully, won't be anytime soon. But, yeah, that's something to think about. One day these videos are gonna end. I don't know when. Hopefully not for a very, very long time, because I'm very happy doing what I do. Get the soul here, which of course is gonna give us a nice little anti-projectile field around us, like those repulsion fields that you see those other champions have. I don't know if, like, I don't know if I'm going to be doing Isaac for the rest of my existence. I hope not. On YouTube. Yeah, I've been wanting to kind of bring back Pokemon openings again. I've been wanting to do, you know, like sort of like monthly content of at least Pokemon stuff, like it's sort of my hobbies, you know. Like if I get like a mystery pack or something, you know, those are always fun to watch. And you know, just try to have fun, you know, just try to share what I enjoy with other people who like to support me. But that is a weird thought to think about, though. One day, the daily Sinvicta uploads will not be here anymore. Not because I'm gonna like die or anything. It's just because, like, I mean, eventually, like, I'm going to have to move on. One day. But again, hopefully not anytime soon. Because I love my job. This job has never felt like a job, and I'm very, very thankful. And privileged to have the people that I do in the mosh pit. And thank you all very much for being here every single day. No matter how long we go. Filigree Feather, I'm going to need you to step it up, son. I haven't seen a banger item yet come out of you. You were called up for a reason. That is not a banger item. Spear of Destiny. And I'm not even going to take Guardian Angel because Guardian Angel is doo-doo. Mom's key is going to make basically all of this very easy. Yeah, that's all I really want. We're going to stick with the Filigree Feather. We do get a payout from this one, and we don't get a payout from the other one. And we do not want Guardian Angel because I do not want Conjoined, and also Guardian Angel is just bad. We got an Emperor card. Boy starts saying to himself, hang on now, buddy. Hang on now. What are you talking about? Guardian Angel's bad. It's one of them there orbitals that can block them shots. Well, the thing is, Cletus, is that it also attracts shots to you. And I don't really want my orbitals doing that. I want my orbitals to simply just be a piece of something that can block shots for me, that orbit me. That's all I want orbitals to be. I don't need them to attract shots to themselves. They're not. You're not that self-important, Orbitals. I'm sorry to say. Didn't even know that was a mimic chest. Check out this library real quick. Book of Secrets and the Necronomicon, but we are going to Necra not take any of those. So looking for Tinted Rocks all along the way here. I have to keep reminding myself that we do have Ouija board, which obviously the Spectral Tears are very useful to have. Something about the Spear of Destiny is that you do not want to... Don't rely upon the Spear of Destiny for basically anything. It does deal damage to things in front of you if they're dumb enough to like hit the spear, or if you like you're good enough to like use it. But it's not like a substitute for like Mom's Knife or something like that. Look at the soul push away the projectiles here. It's really cool whenever you see it like just stopping dead in the tracks. We do get a Devil Deal and we get D-Bizzle. Come on down, D-Bizzle. There goes our Angel Deals. Yeah, we can go see. We can see who this mini boss is real quick. Lust. And look at that. We get spun. Very nice. We get ourselves a nice little damage upgrade and movement speed. And we get a full charge on our Crack the Skizzle for Stanley. Isaac with this face from the side profile looks like Daisy when she's like scared. Daisy has this like little beard. Pretty cute. Little Daisy. But yeah, I mean, I'm gonna be adding some more content to the channel here that's not Isaac. And you know, relatively soon. There are a couple games that are coming out that I'm definitely interested in doing, especially Diablo 4. Obviously, D4 is going to be huge when it comes out in June. I'm going to be playing in early access. All that stuff is going to be happening. So, you know, I don't know if I'll do a full like campaign playthrough. I might just do a campaign playthrough like I did for D2 Resurrected on the gaming channel. But you know, the main channel is here to really push whatever I want. And, you know, like kind of interest people in other games and stuff. And then, like, if I want to continue on with the series like I did with the Minecraft stuff or Library of Runa, that sort of thing, then I'll push it to the gaming channel or Monster Hunter too. So it is nice having two channels, even though I haven't done anything on the gaming channel in quite a while. It is nice having that sort of like freedom to do that. Well, there's Duality. We're definitely going to take Duality here. Yeah, we'll take a quarter and Gimpy. Might as well take Book of the Dead for Bookworm as well. And we need to get a full charge on Crack the Sky. I don't feel like fighting Fallen. Definitely don't feel like fighting Gate. Mega Maw. I definitely don't feel like fighting double Monstro 2. What is this room? There we go. Now we can go fight Lamb. I'm going to wait for Lamb to split here before we use Crack the Sky. For hopefully obvious reasons. As you see, our damage isn't really all that impressive. Even when Lil Bremmy and Seraphim get in the mix here. Nice damage with Crack the Sky. There we go. Got the no hit on Lamb, and yeah, let's go ahead and rip one real quick. It's Friday. Come on. Second seed, Romeo Golf, Romeo 2, Quebec Mike 8, or no, Quebec Mike Bravo 0, not an 8. All right, Filigree Feather, you're getting a second chance here because we've got Duality. I can't lie. I would totally bomb this to see what that was. So I know it's a rules card. So Duality is giving you a second chance here, Filigree Feather. And so far, son, I gotta say, I ain't impressed. Not impressed at all. The Gust is excellent. We got D-Bizzle on the team now. D-Bizzle hasn't even done anything this run yet. So if you get outshined by D-Bizzle, you know you're screwing up. Bizzle with a sun card, reverse sun card, which we do not care about. There goes Fruity Plum. You could probably go fight, what are you thinking, Mother? Thinking Mother or Hushy to Mega Stand. I mean, we haven't fought Mega Satan in a long time. Inner Eye here, which is a very good item for us. Do that Bloody Gust now, increasing our tears rate. I do at least want to go into the store. There's a Tenant Rock up there. There's a Tenant Rock up in them there hills. So starter deck, which is going to give us two slots for... Or sorry, not the two slots, but turn all pills into cards. And also give us two consumable slots. Glowing Hourglass is interesting, but not interesting enough. Nun's Habit, a Birthright here, which gives us three random items. And we'll take Ghost Pepper. Diamonds. Might as well take Piggy Bank here. basically free. And Tarot Cloth, which is going to give us another tarot card. And that gave us... Okay. So if we get a reroll pedestal inside of a secret room, oh baby. Because the reverse justice card is going to proc twice, thanks to Tarot Card. Tarot Cloth. So, yeah. We are wanting a reroll machine, please. Ain't it? If we had Anima Solo, we could actually stop these spikes. But we don't. Crack the Sky has been doing a fairly good job at knocking down these bosses. Ebizzle gives us a Sun card. We don't really care about that. There you go, Crack the Sky doing his thing. Get a movement speed upgrade, which we don't obviously need, and we'll take Stairway as well. Although I am still tempted to use this Justice card in the Angel Deal room. Monstrance. Okay. So, no, it won't spawn Eternal Chests. That's fine. Get a whole bunch of crap, though, and this is a good time for us to have the Stairway. Again, we got the Stairway. Bomb's Key. Kicking butt, taking names for us. Stairway, of course, is going to give us the Angel Deal shop on the next floor. You know what? Yeah, let's fight Mega Stan. We haven't fought Mega Satan in a while, so we're gonna say thank you to the Filigree Feather, maybe. No, we don't need to give it up yet. It's too early to do that. Because that would just be stupid for us to get rid of the Filigree Feather. In fact, it's stupid for us to get rid of it at all. Because what we can do is just simply drop it if we wanted to, and then bomb an Angel Statue, and then just pick it up again. We don't need to leave it behind. So yeah, that's nearsighted thinking there. Finally get a Tears upgrade with Active Contrition. Spirit Sword. Not feeling Spirit Sword. I'm going to pass on Spirit Sword. I think Spirit Sword is good. But it's not what I want right now. I want... We want to get solid tier effects and stuff. Thank you, which is going to give us another Tears up, which we are now capped at. All right, Ebizzle. We got to fill up that Bone Heart. We don't want to lose it. Parasite, okay. Now, the shops, because we have Stairway now, our regular shops become a little devalued, especially since we already have mapping and stuff. Although I will take something like More Options, of course. It's going to give us extra items that drop from our item room. We'll get a second item pedestal, essentially. Excuse me? Another Emperor card. Definitely going to take that. Didn't really want another Bone Heart, but we've got it. Oh, man. Absolutely dunkified. Rare card. Come on, Team Angel Deal. Where's these? We need to see our premier items here. Okay, now we're talking. We get Revelation, which is going to finally give us flying. And we're also going to, of course, get another. We're basically doubling up on Angel Statues right now. Oh, baby. Now we're talking. All right, Team Angel Deal. All right, I see you. I see you working now. The Eternal, or the Holy Grail, which is going to give us more flying, which we don't need anymore, but it's good to have. Ricard and Ace of Clubs. Of course, that would be a bad Gas Mushroom. Oh, there's a double Tinder Rock there. I didn't even see that. And is that... range upgrade's fine. So there's no reason for us to bomb our... Or there's no reason for us to use a key here because we could bomb our way into the item room. And we get a Hermit card, which saves us another key. And I don't really want Chaos because Chaos kind of screws up everything that we're doing with the Filigree Feather. So Hierophant Emperor sounds good to me. And we get Virgo, which is totally irrelevant because we have a starter deck. Yeah, I don't think that Chaos is the right play here. If we were on a usual like Devil Deal run or something like that, then you know maybe. But I'm still trying to give the Filigree Feather the benefit of the doubt here. The Blue Chub. She's got blown out of the water. Immaculate Conception. Impurity, okay. Well, Immaculate Conception is kind of whatever, but I mean, we'll take Purity if we can get the good aura, which is not going to change until we take damage, obviously. And we got the one that doesn't help us. And then Genesis. Genesis does sound... We passed on Genesis last week. And all these repeating angel items are honestly getting a little bit ridiculous. Okay, Book of Virtues. I think we got to go Genesis here. And the reason why, there actually is a strategical reason. The reason why I didn't use it last time is just because we had no reason to use Genesis. Some people are like, well, it can make the run more interesting. No. We don't need to throw away a winning run just because we want to make the run more interesting. No. It doesn't work like that. If there's a strategical reason why we want to use Genesis, then I'll do it. In this case, though, there is a strategical reason because the Angel Deal items that we've been getting from the Filigree Feather have not been incredible. And we have a lot of Angel Deal stock to work with here, and that means that we can potentially get a much more powerful, and I mean much more powerful run than what we've got right now, especially if we're going to go fight Megastan. Ogish. And, I mean, I'll take Lazarus's Rags again. We need to get a key, so I'm going to drop the Filigree Feather. Because, I mean, when we roll Genesis, we're going to get whatever we need out of the Angel Deal pool. Like, that's going to happen. So it's only a matter of, like, not if, but when we get the Angel Deal items that we want from Genesis. And we'll probably drop the other... Yeah, we'll get the other key piece here real quick. Then what we'll do is we'll go fight Boss Rush, then use Genesis, skip to Womb 1, or we can wait till Womb 2. It doesn't really matter. Holy Mantle, of course, just allows us to just kind of skirt through everything here. Euthanasia, fantastic, especially with Parasite. Lost Soul Buddy, check him out now. Fine. Okay, we lost something and gained... damage and tears, so... Take it. How many of you do the Lost Soul Buddy check him out now thing now? I'm very curious about how far my stupidisms have permeated through the Isaac culture here. Because it's just infinitely hilarious to me, just because I'm so... My mind is just so dumb. I mean, I just say the dumbest things in my mind. I'm like, it's just like, why? That doesn't make any sense. But somehow into my brain, I'm like, hey, you know what? That's funny. Maybe someone will laugh. Oh, my God. Mom got destroyed. With a balance again. And this is just giving us, again, more stuff to work with here. When we finally do use Genesis, which will probably be on the next floor. I mean, whatever. New boss rush for funsies. Don't really need to, but... Yeah, you know, it's Friday. We're stomping through content here. Making a mockery of the game. You know how it is. And of course, Parasite and Jacob's Ladder is just just too good. Very, very, very strong. If you're wondering why Revelation is doing that, by the way, it's from Parasite. Don't ask me why it makes a cross. I guess it's the game's version of just splitting things, but... yeah, that's for some odd reason, that's just what happens. What's going on here? That black rune, I don't really want the black rune, thank you. Okay, and there's Cursed Eye, which we are going to take because, again, we're going to Genesis anyway, so. And the HP doesn't matter. None of this really matters. Well, head on down. You're ready for Genesis. Although, now that I think about it... which one of you did that? Now that I think about it, does using Genesis take away your key? The Mega Stand? Star of Bethlehem here. We got promptly pushed out the door. Oh no, lost soul buddy, oh no. Butless Chub, how you doing? We also just wait till we get to the chest, I suppose. Bible, one of the few angel items that we haven't gotten yet, other than Sacred Heart game. Got all these repeat items, but you're not giving us what we want, Team Angel Deal. What's up? What's the deal? What's the deal besides Sacred Heart? We need our champion to come through for us here. I'm not saying that, like, you know, we're in desperate times, call for desperate measures, but hey, I'd like to see Sacred Heart. Because we're going to get Sacred Heart. Like, Sacred Heart is happening. Whether it be via the Filigree Feather or the Angel Shop or Genesis, we're going to get Sacred Heart. I will almost guarantee that. I'm never, ever going to guarantee stuff in Isaac, but I will almost guarantee that we will see Sacred Heart on this run. That's just something that is going to happen. So, however long it takes you for us to get there... this is a very weird sentence game, then, you know, it's up to you, but this is happening. Here goes Mom's Heart. Neither one of these are passive items, unfortunately. And that is Salvation. Okay. So, Sacred Heart. Gotta be here, right? Think you lost soul, buddy. The duality again. All right, now it's the time that we've all been waiting for. Let's see if Genesis... I'm going to wait for the golden key to open up the golden door. The Nod Leaf from Lost Soul, buddy. Check him out now. Get Mitre. This is your last chance, Filigree Feather. You're gone. You're yeeted. Gave us the body. You got every one of the mind, the body, and the soul items. All right, all right, all right, all right. That mega chest here. Hex, and it's going to give us Conjoin, but we're going to immediately lose it because we're going to go screw. All right. Whoa, we're starting with Dead Dove here. Okay. Uric Acid. Don't really want Lard, though. I'm going to take the Rosary for Tears. Holy Mantle, of course. Let's watch how many Angel Deal items we're going to get. Yeah. Movement speed for show. I guess pay to play. Holy Light. We don't need Eucharist anymore. Cricket's Body. Take Mr. Dolly. Don't actually want Tech X. Neptunus. I gotta take Revelation. Uncle Holy Water, come on down. Take School Bag with a balance. Yep. Yep. Stigmata or Hallowed Ground or Pogatory. Give me Pogatory. Champion Belt for sure. BFF for sure. Movement speed is what we want, what we need. Movement speed is what we want, what we need. Tech point five, yes, sir. We don't need Guppy's Eye anymore, so I'm just going to take the pack for damage. Fuel Duplex. Shot speed's pretty doo-doo. Nine lives, just for insurance. There we go. I mean, I did say that it was going to happen. So, Sacred Heart is a go. Gets more shot speed. Never mind. Just kidding. Soul Locket, I guess. Wafer, sure. Ladder doesn't really matter, but we'll just take it anyway. Or Stairway, I mean. Friend Finder, nah. Get Bethlehem. Synth Oil, Salvation. Mind. Sacred Orb. It's going to help us out. Yep. Yes, I will take Guppy's Head. Piercing Shots. Yeah. Inner Eye is just going to be even more incredible damage. Forest Tears Up. Yeah. Okay. Dad's Ring, sure, I guess. Well, Mr. Wayne. Leia, we've got some Torium, Leia. Use it to fight Diablo. What is this even going to look like? Yeah, we'll take Spoonbender. Yeah, we'll take Soy Milk. Toxic Shock? Nah, give me that Play-Doh cookie. Blanket. We'll take you. Parasitoid. Oh, my goodness gracious. D-Bizzle, come on down. Blank was power, I guess. Ongo Baby's a bro. Forget me now. Well, take Deadeye as well. Compound Fracture, sure. I mean, why not? Yeah, Quad Shot, why the hell not? Pyromaniac, brother! Take ourselves Death's Touch. Yeah, give me a movement speed upgrade. Parasite. This with Tractor Beam is going to be insane, by the way. Butt Bombs. This doesn't really matter. I'll take the Shot Speed. Euthanasia is great. Capricorn to raise our tears cap. Yeah, and pH Dizzle. We don't really need Kidney Stone. Quince. Quince is great, but man. Oh, Worm Buddy! Come on down. Yep, Mimic. Maggie's Bow. Black Candida. I mean, 2020. Got Beelzebub. I have Belial, too. And Shielded Tears. Oh, my Gertie. Belly Button, take Incubus. Yeah, sorry, D-Sizzle. Get Birthright here, which gave us Eve's Mascara. Wait, no, that didn't give us Eve's Mascara. This, okay, yeah. So just a pedestal. Mulligan, and yeah. So, now we can't use Forget-Me-Now right now because it would remove our ability to get into the Golden Door, which is the whole point of us doing this. But let's see what these tiers look like, shall we? Okay, I didn't see anything spawn other than like famine and death. And Megastan is dead. Now we're gonna hit Forget Me Now. There we go. Oh my goodness, continuum. I don't think number one is going to affect anything other than just kill our range. So, okay. So the frame rate might be and it crashed. Woo! Yeah, I probably should have seen that one coming. We're stacking way too many tier effects with Cricket's body and C-section. That is a recipe for disaster. Okay, how about we just go? Let's keep it sensible and let's just end it. Okay, never mind. The game is just gonna keep crashing there. Might have to remove an item via console command. I really don't want to if I can avoid it. If it crashes again, I will. But we didn't do anything special. This is not a modded run. This is base repentance here. So what you're seeing is what we're getting. This is repentance acting like repentance. Not exactly the most stable game. Because for many people out there, it says, oh, Isaac doesn't crash unless you're doing something to it. Yeah, it just crashed three times. Okay, so we're probably going to end up having to remove either Godhead, C-section, or Cricket's body. We're just going to start removing things. How about that? I think C-section and Parasite, C-section, and Compound Fracture plus Soy Milk is probably not good for us. So let's remove C-section. Let's remove Parasite. Let's remove Godhead. And let's remove Cricket's body. Okay, let's see if that helps us here. Okay, so far so good. What in the world kind of tiers are these? Again, I don't like going to the console command unless I absolutely have to. What's going on in here? But if it's prohibiting the video from like finishing, especially, and it's just crashing left and right, then like obviously we gotta step in. But my point is that like you shouldn't have to do that. Like the game. The repentance is just not stable enough to handle itself, essentially. So, if you ever have someone who's like, oh, repentance is perfectly stable. If your game crashes, you're running too many mods, or you're obviously doing something to it. Like, no, the game literally just crashes. It just crashed three times in a row there, so. Anyway, what a fantastic run to end this week on. Well, the work week anyway. We have one more run of the week, though, coming up tomorrow. Remember, we are now only three away from our like streak goal of 90 for the keyboard tracking episode. And then after that, going on to the next like streak goal. Thank you for watching, everyone. Have a great start to your weekend. I hope you enjoyed it. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Ivy Bug, Julian LaFond, and Tim Klein. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Invicta.